This is Ather 450, the first scooter in the world to have a touchscreen dashboard and Google Maps for navigation.
This was the first scooter anywhere in the world to deploy a touchscreen dashboard and the first one to have Google Maps.
It was also the fastest accelerating scooter ever produced in India at the time, faster than even other petrol scooters. The company spent 5 years and at least 55 prototypes before coming to this. Today in 2024, electric scooters have become mainstream, but back in 2013, there was no market for these in India. This was when two engineers from IIT Madras decided to build Tesla of electric scooters in India. And the most audacious decision was to completely design and manufacture it in India. It took them 5 years and millions of dollars to go from this to this. And when they launched Ather 450 in 2018, the company had the best product in the market. Also, there was almost no competition. But despite all that, today Ather is way behind the market leaders in India's electric scooter category. And all the three companies that are ahead of Ather launched their scooters much after Ather did. So, what went wrong with Ather? And can it make a comeback? These are the questions I'll try to answer in this episode of Backstage with Millionaires. The story of Ather Energy began in 2009 at one of the most prestigious colleges in India, IIT Madras. Two of its engineering students, Tarun and Swapnil, wanted to do something in the energy space. And their first product was this fan called Famp. The idea here was to use thermal energy from oil lamps and convert it into power to run these fans. Something they thought would be beneficial in remote Indian villages with inadequate power supply. This idea never turned into anything meaningful, but their passion to do something in energy space remained. During their last semester of engineering, Tarun discovered batteries swapping and became convinced that electric vehicles are the future. And for electric vehicles to succeed, the charging infra had to be solved. And so, Tarun and Swapnil's new goal now was to build a battery company. The idea was to manufacture lithium-ion batteries and sell them to EV owners who wanted to refurbish their aging electric vehicles. For the next 6 months, Swapnil and Tarun conducted extensive market research. They spoke to hundreds of EV owners and realized that, by and large, most of them hated their EVs. EVs at the time were underpowered, unreliable, and ugly. And so why would these customers who hated their electric vehicles buy Ather's expensive batteries? At this time, Swapnil came up with a crazy idea. Instead of batteries, why not build an electric vehicle that people actually wanted to buy?
And then Swapnil suggested, "Think both of us are passionate about building a brand. Why were we even thinking of doing this nameless, faceless thing? We should just build a brand, no? We should build a vehicle."
And that is how the journey of building India's first smart electric scooter was started. Now, this was in 2013, and there were many brands who were building electric scooters in India at the time. But there were a ton of issues. Firstly, most of these companies were importing electric scooters and their batteries from China, and the quality was really bad. They couldn't go beyond 30 kilometers per hour and looked very ugly. Heck, they could not even get over a flyover. And because of these reasons, customers were not buying them. Few who did, hated them. And Ather Energy wanted to change this. They were inspired by Tesla. And so, they did not just want to make the best EV scooter. They wanted to make the best scooter. Something that could beat petrol scooters in both performance and design. And for this, they could not just import it from China. They had to build it themselves here in India. Swapnil and Tarun started building their first prototype in the robotics lab of IIT Madras. They started by tearing down a YoXL electric scooter to understand its different components. Things like the shape of its sachets, suspension strength, and other basic dimensions. These measurements were then used to build a makeshift sachet for Ather's first prototype EV. It took them 4 months to build their first prototype, and this is how it looked after completion. Tarun filmed this small video while riding this prototype scooter. This was a great beginning, but the team at Ather had a long way to go. They got a 5 lakh rupees grant from IIT Madras, which helped them make their second prototype. But now, they needed serious money to build something that customers would buy. Their 5 lakh rupees grant had exhausted very quickly, and VCs were not ready to invest money into a young EV company. And so, Tarun and Swapnil took the crowdfunding approach. They decided to take pre-orders for 25 scooters at 85,000 rupees each and use that money to then build the scooters. They gave themselves around 6 months to do this. This early revenue strategy impressed IIT Madras alumnus and entrepreneur Srini V. Srinivasan, who then decided to invest 25 lakh rupees into the company. This pre-seed money allowed Ather's team to move into their first office and also start working on their next prototype. In 2016, Ather announced their first electric scooter, S340, and also claimed that they would start producing them commercially by the end of the same year. And this is when Ather's problems with production started. You see, turning a functional vehicle into a final production vehicle is not as easy as it sounds. The problem was, to build a final scooter, they needed hundreds of automobile vendors who could build these parts for them. The parts that Ather's R&D team had built from scratch in a lab, these vendors had to build them at scale. Tarun's team had designed a component that was 1.5 millimeters thick. And when they went to one of the vendors to cast this component, they said the lowest they could go was 2.5 millimeters. They don't do 1.5 millimeters thick component casting. So basically, Ather's innovation was becoming the reason for their stagnation. The Indian automotive vendors were not equipped to handle Ather's demanding quality requirements. And these vendors did not want to change their entire workflow for a small client like Ather, who hadn't even sold a single scooter, and they didn't know if people would even buy their electric scooter. It was too much of a risk for them. This was when Hero MotoCorp came to save Ather. See, Hero wanted to get on the electric vehicle bandwagon, and Ather, they wanted the support from a giant like Hero to get automobile vendors to listen to them. And so, Hero invested 205 crore rupees in Ather, picking up more than 25% stake. This deal with Hero became a game changer for Ather. Not only did they get enough money for production, but they also got a strategic partner who could help them set up a production facility and meet the right people. People like Venkatesh Padmanabhan, who had turned the fortunes of Royal Enfield and then helped Ather to set up their production facility in Bengaluru, and also get their functional vehicle to production-ready vehicle. And with everything in place, Tarun again came on stage and this time launched Ather 340 and Ather 450 in 2018. These scooters were what Tarun had promised they would be. They were the state-of-the-art ones. They were the first scooters in the world to come up with a touchscreen dashboard, and they had Google Maps to make navigation easy. And that was not all. Remember, Tarun had said he wanted to make better electric scooters than petrol scooters? He did it with Ather 450, which was the fastest accelerating scooter in India at the time, faster than even petrol scooters. Tarun and his team had made the impossible possible, and all that was left now to sell these electric scooters and revolutionize India's EV market. There was no one standing in their way, there was no competition, and Ather was perfectly placed with the support from India's largest two-wheeler manufacturer Hero. But despite all this, Ather still could not succeed. And it had nothing to do with the quality of their scooters. The issue was their price. You see, Tarun and Swapnil wanted to make the best scooter out there. They wanted to put the best features and hardware, and did not take into consideration the cost behind it. So, for their 450 scooters, which they were selling at 1.25 lakh rupees, their production cost was almost 5 lakh rupees.
2019 start, when we were selling the first Ather 450s. It used to cost us about 3.6 lakh rupees as the material cost per vehicle, and an additional about almost 1,20,000 on top of other expenses of assembling and taking other risks on the product. So roughly something like 5 lakh rupees was your cost to build and sell one vehicle.
Yes, 5 lakh rupees to build a scooter, which they were selling at 1.25 lakh rupees. That's more than 350% negative gross margin. And even though they had money in the bank, which they had raised from Hero, it was all burning too fast. In fact, things were so bad that at one point, Tarun and Swapnil had thought about shutting down Ather.
In 2019, we had come this close to actually considering shutting down four-phase the product line and just becoming a technology provider.
They had tried a lot of things, but building an electric scooter from scratch in India was making them bankrupt, and there was no hope. Tarun at this point went to his investors and told them that they would fix this pricing issue within a year, but he had no idea how they would pull it off.
They come into one of our shareholders that pakka promise, if you don't fix this in 1 year, I will get the McKinsey's of the world to come and run this.
He then went to the top consulting firms and asked for their help in getting the costs down. And they all told them one thing. We have never seen automotive costs drop more than 30%. This wasn't enough for Ather. They needed something tangible. So the team went to the drawing board and came up with a plan. Firstly, they decided they will make only 200 scooters a month, even though their factory was capable of producing 2,500 scooters a month. They did this so they were not burning burning money at a pace that would put them out of business sooner. Next, they pulled all the resources they could from Hero, a company that has been making two-wheelers for decades, and understood their processes to make Ather scooters more efficient. And by the start of 2021, Ather had managed to bring down the cost lower than the price they were selling it to their customers. This was a Herculean task, something that Tarun has often talked about in his interviews. For example, this one, where he said that building a hardware product in India is so hard that no Indian startup is building electric scooters in India. Just look at Ola, a company that had billions of dollars in funds, had to import an electric scooter from outside India to start their EV journey.
Look at what Ola's doing, right? They had to import an entire product from outside, because it's a hard journey to build everything from scratch in here.
Finally, in 2021, Ather was a real company with positive gross margins, and it was around the same time that Ola started selling their electric scooters. And while Ather was busy surviving, its competitors like Okinawa, who were importing their scooters from China, were dominating the Indian EV market with close to 40% market share in FY20. By the time Ather had got its shit together in 2021, TVS and Bajaj had also launched their electric scooter, and Ola was just getting ready for their grand launch. Despite being the first, Ather was already too late for the party. And if you compare Ather with these players, TVS and Bajaj had huge distribution networks that were built over decades. Then there was Ola Electric, which was spending millions of dollars on marketing to get customers. Ather did not have much to show. Yes, their product was made in India, and it was apparently better quality, but this did not help them sell more. In whole of FY20, Ather sold close to 3,000 scooters. Compare this to Ola Electric, which got more than 80,000 bookings within just 12 hours of the launch. In fact, even if you combine Ather's sales of 4 years from FY19 to 22, it's still way less than Ola's pre-booking numbers. So, why is that? The problem was, despite fixing their major issues, Ather was too busy perfecting their scooters. They thought this focus on quality was enough to get them the customers. But they were clearly wrong. Just look at Ola. They have made the news for a lot of wrong reasons, from their scooters malfunctioning to them catching fire. But this did not make a dent in their growth. In fact, Ola is the number one electric scooter company in India with a market share of more than 50%. Take a look at this 2019 Forbes article. Here, Tarun said that Ather's success will depend on their product development and their after-sales customer service. He never mentioned marketing. But then, in this interview with Nikhil Kamath, he goes on to accept the fact that Ather messed up when it comes to marketing.
The biggest problem that we discover is that people don't even know what is Ather. Biggest feedback that I get is that most people think that if they have heard of Ather, ye koi European, Norwegian company hogi.
Even though Ather has recently started putting more money into marketing, it's an uphill battle. Now that EV space is a lot more crowded than it was back in 2018, when Ather was the only one. But does that mean Ather has lost the game? Absolutely not. So far, you have only heard me talk about how Ather has failed to become a leader in a category that they created in India. But the reason I wanted to highlight their journey was to show exactly how difficult it is to build a hardware technology company out of India. And that's the reason most companies don't do it. From a pure growth perspective, it makes sense for a company to simply import the technology and start selling it in India. It's a winning strategy. Just look at Ola. We have seen it play out over and over again. But I'll be honest, I'm a little biased towards Ather, and I want them to win. Not because I have a personal stake in the company, but because Ather's win means something bigger. It means that you can successfully build a hardware technology startup in India. And even though Ather might be behind giants like Ola, TVS and Bajaj, they have built a reputation for quality. They have built the Tesla's equivalent of an electric scooter from India. And you can see that from all these comments from their customers. In fact, in the same podcast with Nikhil, where he mentioned how Ather messed up in marketing, he also says that Ather won when it comes to word of mouth.
So we may not have marketed the product well, so not enough people may buy it today. But the ones who are buying it have a better word of mouth for us than many of our competitors.
That's been their growth driver. And just look at these numbers. Their revenue has been growing significantly since FY21. And a lot of this has to do with them making top quality scooters that their customers love to brag about. Now, another reason why Ather stayed behind in the race is that they were focused on the premium market. When they started, their customers wanted a premium product, and that's what they were building. That was a period when only early adopters were buying electric scooters and they wanted a premium product. But now everyone wants one. And their customers have been complaining that their scooters are not family friendly and too small for a family. And their latest product Rista is the answer to that. They have tried to fix all the issues people had with Ather 450 and 450X and created Rista for the mass market. And finally, Ather is bullish on software. Tarun believes that over the long term, electric vehicles won't make money from servicing, as there aren't a lot of parts to repair like a traditional vehicle, be it cars or scooters. He thinks that companies will have to make money by selling software and technology upgrades like batteries and accessories.
I think long-term electric vehicles will have to make money on something else. You'll have to make money on most likely upgrades. They'll have to make money on accessories. They'll have to make money on generally technology upgrades.
Once you buy an electric scooter, you can change your battery and it will feel like a new scooter. Next, you can get new software upgrades over the year, which can improve its performance. In fact, Tarun claims that even today, while 85% of their revenue is coming from selling the scooters, the remaining 15% is coming from selling software upgrades. And it's only going to increase. Ather does not charge the customers separately for the software, but that price is included in the price of the vehicle. And by software upgrades, I mean Ather Stack, which basically is the OS of your Ather scooter and controls everything you do on your device. On top of that, they've also introduced smart accessories like Ather Halo Helmet. Just like Apple, Ather wants to create an entire ecosystem for its customers. In the end, let me know your opinions. Do you think Ather's focus on quality can beat Ola Electric's huge scale? Also, do you personally own an Ather and how has been your experience? Share with us in the comments and I'll see you in the next one.